the difference between the people that walk out these doors in a few minutes and say, man, that was just another average weekend for me. And the difference between the people that walk out these doors in a few minutes and say, this weekend was a transforming, defining moment in my life. The difference between those two is this much. It's this much. You guys, I'm going to give it to you like it is. You can have 99% of it right. You can have it all. But if you're missing this much, you're going to fail. But the good news is, you can mess this all up. You can do everything inside out, upside down, and backwards. You can forget half the stuff you guys heard the last 2 days. But if you get this much right, you are guaranteed to win. It comes down to this much. You guys, everything you've gotten this weekend, what your notebooks are full of, everything in your brains, you've gotten the 99%. We gave it to you. You have everything that you need. But leaving here, the only thing that matters is that you really got this much. You've heard what I'm referring to from every speaker that's hit this stage. Some have called it belief. Some have called it hope. Some have called it heart. I call it faith. No matter what word you use, here's what this means. This much. What am I looking for, team? What am I looking for? I'm looking for what? This much. You guys, this much is an unconditional belief. It's a knowing, as Neo says. You guys, everybody that crossed this stage with a big check, everybody that crossed this stage with a $1 million pendant, they have a belief, a knowing, that we have the products that if we put in people's bodies, we have the ability to transform their health. Ladies and gentlemen, after seeing the stories on stage this weekend, do you have that belief? Yes or no?
Yes!
Everybody that crossed this stage, we believe that we have an opportunity that is an ultimate equalizer, that anybody, doesn't matter your age, your race, your ethnicity, your gender, what degrees you have, how smart you are, we have a belief that we have an opportunity that if you bring a desire, you can make it happen and you can have your dreams come true. We believe that. Do you believe that, Visalis? I believe that you have a leadership team. Between myself, Nick, and Ryan, and the people that we represent, that really genuinely cares about each and every one of you and the families throughout the Vi community, and that we will always do everything with your best interest in mind. You guys, after hearing us on the stage the last 2 days, do you believe that? Do you really believe that? You guys, everything that's crossed the stage here this weekend, it's been us trying to give you an example of our commitment to you. But our commitment to you, that's the 99%. It matters. It's important. We need to be committed to you and your families and your goals, but I need to tell you guys, that's the 99%. This much that matters isn't about our commitment to you. This much that matters is about your commitment to yourself. That's what this much is about. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to throw this on the board. Here's what I'm going to ask all of you guys to do before you exit these doors. I'm going to ask you to make a commitment. A what? A commitment. There's an interesting word. There's a word I think is undervalued and underutilized and underhonored in society today. True commitments. And you know what? Here's the reality. I'm not going to tell you what the commitment needs to be. I'm going to challenge you. You guys like challenges, don't you? How many of you guys are always up for a challenge in the room? You guys, I'm going to challenge you to make a commitment to yourself. I'm going to challenge you to make a commitment that you can do between now and the end of this month that you know you need to do to take your step forward for your business and your dream. Now, I hope a lot of people commit to getting their what? To getting their what? Because if all of us do that, if all of us take that step forward, you guys, we win. But I'm not going to make you make that commitment. The only thing I'm going to say is whatever commitment you make, you honor to yourself before the end of this month. Is that a fair request to each and every one of you? Is that a fair request? It might be decide to call all your customers and tell them about Nutribar. It might be to go call everybody that said no to the challenge and talk to them about Neon Energy Club. It might be you're going to put in, you know, a certain amount of time between now and the end of the month. I don't care what the commitment is. I just care that you make a what? That you make a what? Commit. And you stick to it. I want 100% of the people that are in this room right now to honor their commitments to themselves. Because, guys, if we can't just start there, then the last 2 days was a waste of time. Is it okay if I be honest with you guys? It was a waste of time. But if we can start with making commitments to ourselves and honoring the commitments to ourselves, you guys, then we can build on that foundation and go do what we're capable of. When you walk outside these doors, all that's still gonna be there. That little feeling that some of you have right now when I asked you to make a commitment, how many of you guys already had that little feeling start to come up? You guys, it's there. You heard Neo talk about it. You heard Kyle Pacetti talking about it. That fear is there. I can see it. Make a commitment. There it is. We walk outside those doors, it's still going to be there. But you guys, if there's one thing I've learned that fear and faith cannot exist in the same place at the exact same time. And what you feed grows, and what you starve dies. We gotta rely on faith. Can we do this? Guys, it's not gonna be easy. We're not here to tell you it's gonna be easy. You know what's easy? Fear is easy. Being down, that's easy. Standing up, that's tough. Fear is easy. Faith is tough. Quitting, that's easy. Giving up, that's easy. Finishing what you started, doing what you said you were going to do, that's tough. Worrying about yourself, that's easy. Putting those you care about in front of your own needs, that's tough. Standing in a room, smiling and clapping and being excited in this environment, that's easy. Making a commitment and honoring a commitment to ourselves, that's tough. But you guys, even though having faith is tough, it's worth it. It's worth it. It's worth it. You guys want to know what I have faith in? Oh, you don't care? I'm not going to tell you. You guys want to know what I have faith in? You want to know what I have faith in? Here's what I have faith in. I have faith in we have the right people in the room right now to go create wave 3-4 Visalis. That's what I have faith in. Oh, you guys, there's a principle that was developed in the 1920s, all about waves of momentum. You can look it up. It's called the Elliott Wave Principle. It studied economic trends to predict patterns. And here's what that principle said. It said, most companies never even have a first wave. And then it said, you know what? The ones that have a first wave tend to have a second wave. And it said, most companies never get to a third wave. But here's what the Elliott Wave Principle says. It says the ones that get to the third wave is always the biggest catalyst. The third wave is the wave that creates legacy brands. The third wave is the wave that matters most. The third wave is the wave that counts. And I believe, I have faith that we have the people in the room to create the third wave. Nick said, we're on a march to create a legacy for 2,000 families. 400 of them are in the room. You saw them on stage. No. Not 400 of them. 400 of them are in the room. I think all 2,000 are in the room. You guys, in a minute, we're going to close out with something I put together just to create an experience for all of us that are here. If I can ask all my Vimillionaires to make their way to stage and join me up here. You guys, I found a collection of messages that I think represents what this event is about for Visalis. I want all of you guys to come forward. This is the end. We're going to be finishing in a couple minutes. If I can have my Vimillionaires on stage and the rest of you guys come forward. If we're going to be here, you guys, I want you to be here for the next few minutes. You see, I have a belief that when you look at life, you can either say that nothing's a miracle or everything's a miracle. You can have a belief that every one of us are in here by complete chance, complete happenstance, total coincidence, a bunch of randoms coming together for some Kansas City barbecue and a little bit of celebration. Or you can believe that every single person in this room, and yes, I'm talking to every single one of you, you can believe that every single one of us are here right now for a reason. You can believe that. Ladies and gentlemen, what if all the experiences we have had, and I'm not just talking about the highs, I'm talking about the peaks, but I'm talking about the valleys. What if every time you've been knocked down, every challenge you have had, every time life has spit you up and kicked you out, every bruise we have, what if all of those were just preparing us for the opportunity we have right now? Ladies and gentlemen, you saw people on stage that represented wave one. You heard stories of our Vimillionaires on stage that led wave two. When they were in those moments, when those waves were beginning, they didn't know what they were about to do. They didn't know what part they were about to play, but they had faith. They had what?
Faith.
And if every single one of us have those same beliefs, then I promise you what we're about to do as a community is very special. You guys, I'm going to play you here in a minute a series of messages from voices you may recognize. And I'm going to ask you to close your eyes, and I'm going to ask you not just to listen to these words, but really hear these words. Everybody take a deep breath. And out. One more time, all the way in. And out. You guys, push everything out of your mind. All that stuff that's out there is gonna be there anyway. Right now, promise me you can be present. Can you do that for me? Say yes. Close your eyes. Deep breaths. Hear these words. Understand that you're here for a reason. We're all here for a reason. And something special is about to start right now.
You can't connect the dots looking forward. You can only connect them looking backwards. So you have to trust that the dots will somehow connect in your future. You have to trust in something.
Deep breaths.
Your gut, destiny, life, karma, whatever. Because believing that the dots will connect down the road will give you the confidence to follow your heart, even when it leads you off the well-worn path, and that will make all the difference. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living with the results of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. You've got to find what you love. And that is as true for work as it is for your lovers. Your work is going to fill a large part of your life, and the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If
keep
you
breathing.
Haven't found it yet, keep looking, and don't settle. Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become.
But you're going to have some ups and you're going to have some downs. Most people give up on themselves easily. You know the human spirit is powerful? There's nothing as powerful. It's hard to kill the human spirit. Anybody can feel good when they have their health, their bills are paid, they have happy relationships. Anybody can be positive then. Anybody can have a larger vision then. Anybody can have faith under those kinds of circumstances. The real challenge of growth, mentally, emotionally, and spiritually, comes when you get knocked down. It takes courage to act. Part of being hungry when you've been defeated, it takes courage to start over again.
You guys have that courage. Keep your eyes closed. Keep breathing. Keep focusing. Listen.
Fear kills dreams. Fear kills hope. Fear put people in the hospital. Fear can age you, can hold you back from doing something that you know within yourself that you're capable of doing, but it will paralyze you.
At the end of your feelings is nothing. But at the end of every principle is a promise. Behind your little feelings, it might not be absolutely nothing at the end of your little feelings. But behind every principle is a promise. And some of you in your life, the reason why you're not at your goal right now, because you're just all about your feelings. You all on your feelings. You don't feel like waking up. So who does? Every day you say no to your dreams, you might be pushing your dreams back a whole 6 months, a whole year. That one single day, that one day you didn't get up could have pushed your stuff back I don't know how long.
Don't allow your emotions to control you. We are emotional, but you want to begin to discipline your emotion. If you don't discipline and contain your emotions, they will use you. You want it, and you're going to go all out to have it. It's not going to be easy when you want to change. It's not easy. If it were in fact easy, everybody would do it. But if you're serious, you'll go all out. I'm in control here. I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm not going to let this destroy me. I'm coming back.
You're coming back.
And I'll be stronger and better because of it. You have got to make a declaration.
You're here for a reason.
This is what you stand for.
This is what
you're standing up for. Your dreams. You're standing up for peace of mind. You're standing up for health. Take full responsibility for your life. Accept where you are and the responsibility that you're going to take yourself where you want to go.
You have what it takes.
You can decide that I'm going to live each day as if it were my last.
It's about life.
Live your life with passion.
Open your eyes, Vaisalas. Put your arms around the
with
person next
drive.
To you.
Decide that you're going to push yourself. The last chapter to your life has not been written yet. And it doesn't matter about what happened yesterday. It doesn't matter about what happens to you. What matters is, what are you going to do about it?
What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do about it?
This year, I will make this goal become a reality. I won't talk about it anymore. I can.
You can.
I can.
You can. We can. Vaisalas, do you feel that? Can you feel that? Can you feel that? That is this much. That is this much. And if you can leave with this much, you can go change your life. And if all of us in this room, if all of us can live with this much, well, ladies and gentlemen, we can change our towns, we can change our cities, we can change our states, we can change the countries, we can change the world if all of us give it this much. I'm committed. Are you committed? We are committed. Are you committed? Well then, ladies and gentlemen, wave three starts now. Thank you guys for an amazing weekend. Thank you for giving us your heart. And let's go show the world what Vaisalas stands for. I will see all of you on this stage. Come Orlando.